when I was a little girl. First of all, me and Mommy used to troop everywhere. Mommy wasn't just a real young mother, because she was already married and all that kind of good stuff, so I'm not like one of those little out of wedlock kids and nothing like that. But me and Mommy used to troop everywhere, and her and my dad used to be kind of wild back in their day. And everybody always says I'm a lot like my mommy was then, how I am now. And I used to sing all the little commercials, used to come on TV, and every time we used to pass by something like a Burger King sign or a McDonald's sign, I bust out with the little song. The commercials, sing, I love them. And my auntie said I used to sing all Steve Wonder songs, Earth, Wind & Fire. My daddy was a huge Johnny Guitar Watson and Ohio Players fan. And we used to sing all the little stuff, the Sweet Sticky Things and Skin Tight and Heaven Must Feel Like This and all the real motherfucker. All those little songs. Everybody said that when I first started talking that I was singing when I was talking. So that's like, you know, to my recollection, like when I was 3, I can remember singing some stuff. And remember being, you know, reasonably on key. My grandma used to be in this club, rest of all, in this club called Beautiful Lilies. And they used to meet 4th Sunday every month and play Pekino and everybody bring a dish. And I used to hang out with my grandmother all the time. So she would, you know, I'd tell a club members, you know, Joy can sing, honey. I think she's gonna be a little singer. All this kind of stuff. And I can remember singing, You Light Up My Life by Debbie Boone. At the meeting. And that's the first song I can ever remember singing completely on key and just really feeling it and having all the little expressions and all the little drama to go along with it. And then when I was in church, Pastor Miles used to always like for me to sing my little song when the youth choir would sing, and it was called What a Difference, and I used to sing it, and I used to just stand up there with my little head cocked, just close my eyes and just sing it. Everybody used to say that I sounded like a grown woman then, but of course I couldn't tell. To me, I sounded like a kid, but everybody was like, you know, she really doesn't have a mature voice to be so little. She sounds like a grown woman. Those are the songs I can remember singing early on. And then after that, went on with the little ballet and the little jazz and just all that little stuff that has to do with theatrics and just art and, you know, all that. And Mommy kind of pushed that, not like forcibly, but, you know, just sort of encouraged it. And I embraced it. And it was cool. And I just kind of took all those little elements in to just, you know, get into performing in front of people and not being scared and taking all the little energy and stuff that I felt and not letting it be nervous energy, but just a little more adrenaline, a little more energy for the show that I had to do. And by the time it came time for me to even get in the frame of mind of performing in front of, hopefully, thousands and thousands of people, that it almost just becomes second nature now. And it's not like a nerves thing, anything like that. I just feel, you know, crazy anxious and crazy comfortable.
Oh, hi there. Well, I was just gonna look at myself.
It's refreshing here, you know. Black artists come out and come real, you know? I mean, Joy has like a song on her album in Latin. I mean, she's freaking the whole thing, you know?
Adoramus Te Christe is a Latin motet, 18th century by Gasparini. I learned that when I was in high school, and I thought that was just a beautiful piece that always meant a lot to me. And it says, Adoramus Te Christe, Te Christe, Te Christe, et benedicimus ti, qui aper sanctum crucem tu, aper sanctum crucem tu. Redemisti mundum, redemisti mundum. And that means, Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world, have mercy on us, grant us peace. For those of you who are Christians.
You know, like Dallas is, he has a lot of aces up his sleeve, you know what I'm saying? It's like, just when people kind of like look at him and go, what you gonna do now? You done did this. He turns around and just totally flips the whole scenario on him, man. And gets into something else of substance. And I mean, he literally is like the boy wonder, man. He got the Midas touch, you know what I'm saying?
You choose to invade my thoughts.
Short hair is good. Because when you cut your hair short, you don't have anything to hide behind. I think that's why I cut mine off, because I never had just crazy long hair, but it was shoulder length, and that was always like a sort of an asset I felt. And I was like, well, what would be dope, and what would really put my self-confidence to the test? Cut all your hair off and let everybody just have to look at your face and not have nothing to hide behind. And that's what I did. And I cut it all off, and I just sort of really, really just engulfed myself in that whole just, there's my face. And not having nothing to hide behind. Everybody says I still kind of hide them behind my big earrings because they still kind of frame my face like I had those. Still, it's not hair. I don't mind. It's actually a real happy little upbeat tune. I freestyled that particular. But it just speaks about how when you're getting over someone, or actually when you're still in love and they've left you, there's not really anything you can do, but you just kind of want any piece of them at all, you know, even if it's, oh, just come over to my house and just lay with me, or if it's, oh, just hold my hand, or just look at me, or just give me conversation, just whatever you do, just something, I don't mind.
If we weren't shooter, we would still meet together somewhere back in yesterday. But then we would not have the strength of today if we weren't who we were. The lingering laugh of souls lost in love would still haunt me day and night. I honestly thought we'd be alright if we weren't who we were. There would not be two hearts broken from lies, tortured by fear and pride. Honesty has nothing to hide, and we were who we were. Even my thoughts can penetrate your heart to forgive me. But since when can a wounded eye see? If we weren't who we were.
That's one of the few cuts I produced on the album.